Hi, and welcome to this presentation of fume hoods and wet benches at DTU Danchip. In the clean room at Danchip, we have several different fume hoods and wet benches. Many of them we have here in clean room D3. When you want to use fume hoods and wet benches, first of all, you should read the manual and the APV for the equipment. And you will find the manual in the areas where we have the fume hoods, wet benches, and other chemical equipment. You can also find all manuals online. You can go to Lab Manager, Equipment Info, and then you find the equipment you are interested in. Go to the Documents tab, and then you can find manuals, APVs, and other relevant information. Let's take a look at the fume hoods and wet benches we have in this clean room. So although fume hoods and wet benches, they look very similar, they work very differently. And we'll take a look at the wet benches later. In this room, we have 8 fume hoods in total, 4 on this side and 4 on the opposite side. And we have 2 different types of fume hoods, one for working with acids and bases and another type for working with solvents. And we'll take a closer look at both of them. You can see all fume hoods have been named. So this is also the name they have in Lab Manager. So the name tells you something about the intended application of the fume hood. And depending on which process you would like to run, what you would like to do, there are certain fume hoods that are dedicated certain types of processes. And you can find more information about this in the manual. For instance, if you would like to dice wafers, we have a dedicated fume hood for this process. Besides the name, we also have color coding of all the fume hoods. And these color coding will indicate the glassware that belongs to each fume hood. So fume hood 2 is red, and that means that glassware for this fume hood is also marked red, so you know that this is the glassware that belongs to this fume hood. So make sure you put it back in the right place when you are done using it. Let's take a look at how to get started using a fume hood or a wet bench. First of all, we should check the so-called traffic lights, because they will indicate whether the fume hood is ready for use. If you see a red light, it could mean either that the fume hood is out of use in Lab Manager, so there's a problem with the fume hood that we are looking into. It may also mean that we have exceeded the ventilation capacity in the clean room. So this is not necessarily a safety problem, but it can easily be a cleanliness problem, because we need to maintain an overpressure in the clean room at all times to maintain cleanliness. So if you see a red light, please contact Danchip, and we will look into the problem. If you see a yellow light, it means that we are approaching the ventilation capacity in the clean room. So again, we may compromise cleanliness if we work at this pressure in the clean room. So usually it's because we're using too many fume hoods or wet benches at the same time. So if you see a yellow light, try and see if there's an unused fume hood with an open sash. Close the sash and then you should get a green light. If you don't, then contact Danchip and we will look into it. But now in this case we have a green light, so we can continue. The fume hood is ready for use and the ventilation is okay. Then we need to wake up the fume hood, because when it's not in use, it's in standby. So to do this, we simply press the front window up arrow. Then we will start the ventilation. And when the ventilation has started, the sash will open and we can proceed using the fume hood. We can switch on lights so we can see what we're doing. And then also before starting your work, remember to check that the sash height is suitable for you. Try to keep it at chest height or lower. So if you need to adjust the position of the sash, you can press the down arrow, and you can press the down arrow again when you want the sash to stop. So now the fume hood is ready for use, and we can start our process. The fume hoods have been designed primarily with safety in mind. So the all the air going through a fume hood is extracted from the clean room and into the fume hood. And this is to have an airflow away from us when we are using the fume hood, and thus preventing chemicals or other vapors escaping from the fume hood. The air sucked into the fume hood leaves via this perforated tabletop, and also partly by some vents in the top of the fume hood. But since the perforated tabletop is a important part of airflow, it's also important not to block this airflow. So don't place clean room papers or large amounts of paper, because that will limit the airflow, and that could also compromise safety or give you an alarm. When working with the fume hood, we also have a few general rules. So one of them, of course, if you have chemicals in the fume hood, don't put your head inside the fume hood, because that is not safe. And also, if work is in progress with chemicals in a fume hood, don't sit on a chair in front of the fume hood, because if there's an accident and a spill of chemicals, you risk spilling chemicals in your lab, and that is definitely not a nice situation. And also, when using a fume hood, then keep in mind that a fume hood is only safe if you work correctly, so don't make any sudden moves, especially moving things in and out of the fume hood, because you create turbulence and you can actually extract chemical fumes if you are moving too quickly. So move slowly and don't make sudden moves in and out of the fume hood. Working with chemicals, pouring, mixing chemicals, then also remember, don't work too close to the sash opening, because that could also mean we could have an escape of chemical vapors. Move your setup a little into the fume hood, so still you can reach the beakers comfortably, but safety is increased significantly when you work a little into the fume hood instead of at the edge of the fume hood. All the fume hoods also have drawers in the bottom, so you can find glassware, plasticware, beakers, and thermometers, what you may need for your process. So check the labels and place beakers correctly, and observe the color coding of the fume hood and glassware as mentioned earlier. When you're done using glassware or beakers, you rinse them and then you put it back in the drawers. Even though it's wet, you just leave it to dry in the drawers, and then we have a clean and tidy fume hood ready for the next user. And a final thing to keep in mind is also watch out that you don't block the sash opening. There's an optical path that checks that nothing is blocking the sash, because even just a tiny thing like a wafer box or a DI water hose or even a 4-H glove, that will block the sash opening, so you will not be able to close the sash with the down arrow, and you will also block the standby function of the fume hood, which otherwise means that if the fume hood is not used for some time, the sash will close automatically, the ventilation will go into standby mode, and we will thus save a lot of energy. So don't block the sash opening, because you will also block the standby feature and you will not be able to close the sash.